Basically, it's a hyped up fish oil. It's the omega-3 oils. But here's the thing. High triglycerides is incredibly prevalent. You see it in 25, maybe 30% of certain demographics, certain groups. And do they really need to be taking the newest, most expensive treatment, especially when it's something like fish oil? Well, there's actually something that's even easier, less expensive than any of that. And there seems to be, again, as usual, a major focus on medications, prescriptions, and maybe not enough focus on lifestyle. Look at the newest, the latest, the biggest thing in high triglyceride treatment. It's Eicosapent Ethyl. There was a New England Journal article about it in January of 2019. Then the following editorials. Now, it is a very impressive medication. So, first of all, what is high triglycerides? And again, what are the ignored treatments? Back to the biochemical part, you remember a triglyceride is a glycerol. You add three fatty acids to it, and the glycerol hooks the three fatty acids together. In other words, it's that fat. Most of us recognize it as saddlebags. Now, if you look on the internet, most folks will say, well, look, there are six ways of having elevated triglycerides. You may have seen some of my videos as well. I talk about high triglyceride over HDL ratio, and that is a very important thing. Most patients that come to me, if they haven't had my labs yet and they don't have an OGTT, a glucose tolerance test, or an insulin survey, almost all of them will have a triglyceride and an HDL, because you'll see both of those on the cholesterol panel. Again, if you look at the internet, they'll say, okay, here are the causes. And there's a lot of agreement over what you can treat and what you can't treat. For example, as you get older, triglycerides tend to get higher. Their gender is an issue that you can't change either. Males are more likely to have high triglycerides. There are other hereditary factors and other diseases which sometimes you can't control. You can control the amount of sugar that you eat, and that is a big deal. That is the lifestyle issue that I go over time and time again. Now, there's a lot of agreement that you can control your obesity. I would say it's not quite so easy. I think there's a lot of people, obese people walking around that would be bear testament to that fact. I'm not going to go down that bunny hole of talking about the success rates. Well, I will. Just real quick, I'm having most of my patients, over half, coming into me now, or coming in from the YouTube channel, and over half of them come to me saying, you know what, I've already lost, and again, over 30 pounds. They're doing it by decreasing sugar, decreasing carbs, not just sugars, but all carbs, stabilizing their insulin values, and then decreasing that eating window. So yes, you can control obesity, believe it or not, and despite all of the obese people you see walking around, there is a much bigger way of controlling obesity, a much better way, and it's happening more and more. Then they get to, as we mentioned in the beginning of this video, medications, like expensive medications like Eicosapent Ethyl. Now, there are some places in the internet, you start looking around, you'll see neglected treatments for high triglycerides. Lose weight, cut your sugar intake, consider going keto. Consuming fiber, eating nuts, get your omega-3 fatty acids from the real thing, eating fish. Exercise, limit your alcohol, and even do intermittent fasting or prolonged fasting. Now let's just go ask a quick question. What is hypertriglyceridemia? Hyper means too much, hypo means too little. So hyper is too many triglycerides. That's what we're talking about. Emia means in the blood. So again, it's too many of these triglycerides in the blood. Now, why do you get that with insulin resistance? Why do men get that? Why do you get it as you're older? Because you tend to get insulin resistance quicker if you're a man, quicker as you get older, and quicker as you get more obese. Insulin, as many people know, decreases blood sugar by opening up the channels in our cells so we decrease blood sugar. But what most people don't know is that insulin decreases fat burning, or decreases the burning of triglycerides. Hence the book and the concept, why we get fat and what to do about it. That book makes the statement that, you know what, maybe we're not getting fat as we get older because we're eating more. Maybe we're eating more because we're getting fat. Now, what does that mean? Well, we're getting insulin resistance, so our insulin is cranking up, 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 up. And as insulin cranks up, our ability to burn that fat and decrease those saddlebags, decrease that subcutaneous fat, as we increase that basal insulin level, we decrease our ability to burn that fat. If you have more interest in that, look it up. It's the endocrine theory of weight gain. So this was a brief video looking at a little bit different perspective on hypertriglyceridemia, high triglycerides. We'll cover more in a series. Thanks for your interest. My name is Ford Brewer. I started off as an ER doc, became very frustrated with the fact that most things that bring people into the ER were preventable, like heart attack and stroke. I went to Johns Hopkins to get training and ended up running the program there in prevention. There I trained dozens of docs, and again, that was 3 decades ago. Since then, I've trained thousands of docs, and even more importantly, supervised those docs, and even most importantly, helped thousands of patients prevent things like heart attack and stroke. Waiting for the disease and hoping for a cure for this kind of devastation doesn't work. Come to Louisville November 8th and 9th. We have a boot camp type of environment for 2 days where you learn all the things that you didn't learn from your doc in terms of heart attack, stroke prevention, things like cardiovascular inflammation, how to detect it, how to measure it, things like insulin resistance, the number one cause of inflammation, how to detect it, how to measure it, how to stop it, how to manage it. You also get, you can get the labs there for that event if you'd like, and get a complete evaluation. In addition, you get an arterial scan called a CIMT. To get the right one of those is fairly difficult. So I'm looking forward to seeing you there. Thanks.